You are conceived. And then your mum has a little trouble squeezing you out because of your larger than average head. And then your parents waste the only time that they are truly happy together on the one time of your life you'll never be able to remember. And then a couple of years later, a younger sibling is born, and you get so jealous that your dad has to buy you a Kinder Egg.
Some milky chocolate.
And then you go to primary school and decide that you want to be a bank manager because that's where the money's really at. And then you go to secondary school, in school uniform several sizes too big and a rucksack almost as tall as you are. And then around year 9, you start to notice people in your class walking and talking differently and wearing clothes that aren't entirely functional. And then the longer you're at school, the more you end up hating everyone. So you skip class to get stoned in the playing fields before catching a movie at the local multiplex. And feel as though you're learning a lot more about the facts of life than you ever would have during triple physics. And then you take exams, but you think it's a joke that your adult life is going to be based on decisions you made barely aged 18. And then coming home one day, you find your parents arguing over who lost the TV remote, and you wonder if anyone ever really grows up or whether they just get older. And then you leave school and get a job working nights cleaning the marble floors of an office skyscraper. And one night, you stop and look out the window at the city below and watch the whole world getting on just fine without you. And then you get another job in a warehouse unloading trucks and listening to the other men talk about how many women they fucked, hoping they won't realize that the last time you even held hands with a girl was in year 2 on a trip to the science museum. And then over the years, you save up enough to move out and rent a dingy one-bedroom flat. You try and make it seem like your home by putting up posters that reflect you as a person, but it always seems fake, as though you're trying to convince yourself of your own personality by leaving up A1 size reminders on the wall. And then you bump into a woman who lives in the flat opposite yours. And then you have coffee, and then a couple of drinks. And then she says, "Life is harder for people who aim to exist than for those who just want to survive." And then you spend more and more time with her and discover that she likes Chanel Rouge Cocoa Lipstick, Brown Sugar, and Sesame Street. And then, you're not a virgin anymore, but it feels like a bit of an anticlimax. And the years start to go by with her. But the more intimately you get to know each other, the more you realize you don't have in common. That it's kind of creepy for a grown woman to still watch Sesame Street, and that red lipstick actually makes her look like a sad clown. But then, really, you've always thought these things about her. But you were just being polite and horny. And then you move out and discover that you saved a small fortune from working with those guys who talk about how many women they fucked. So you sell your possessions and move to the equator by the coast where you have enough money to live comfortably, but you learn to fish anyway and earn a little extra selling what you've caught. And sometimes you stay out on your boat all night making up constellations that only exist for you. And then the local children follow you home from the sea, the stranger who doesn't speak their language. And then one day, when you're on the toilet, you look down and realize it's been months since you've even thought about sex. And you understand that with your libido ebbing away, all those pornos, online dating sites, Facebook stalking and rubbernecking at the bus stop have been useless cotton wool, taking up space in your brain that could have otherwise been used for something more meaningful if only you had had the balls to castrate yourself in your youth. And then, as you spend each day around noon hauling back your catch, you start to feel as though it's not fish that weigh you down, but memories, happy or regretful, each one perfectly preserved like a ship in a bottle. Painfully nostalgic and growing heavier with age, as you now understand that you have more to look back upon than you do to look forward. And then your hair looks more grey than any other colour, and the children that followed you home are now young men and women who help you push out your boat, and then your back hurts, and your eyes hurt, and your hands don't close properly anymore. And when you look in the mirror, you can see how deep the wrinkles in your face are, like cuts. And then you lay in bed, not asleep, and not awake, but always tired. And then you find yourself waiting for the tunnel of light, the series of images from your life flashing before your eyes, but nothing comes. And then you wonder what kind of impact you've made upon the earth, if there's anyone who will realize that you're gone, but before you can think of someone, your heart stops.